In the event that a fallen worker is suspended on their fall arrest lanyard, a prompt rescue is critical. So here are a few ways to use the JAG Rescue Kit to release a fallen worker from their fall arrest lanyard and provide an efficient evacuation. If within reach, connect directly to the fallen worker's harness. To perform the rescue, connect the carabiner on the JAG system to the anchor. Then, clip the carabiner on the rope end of the system to an appropriate harness attachment point, and then remove any slack in the rope by pulling any excess rope through the ID until it is tight. Ensure that the cam on the haul system is engaged and pull on the haul rope to raise the worker until their fall arrest lanyard is unweighted. Once unweighted, disconnect the worker's fall arrest lanyard from either their harness or from the anchor and lower them using the I’D EVAC descender. A tag line can be used to help prevent contact with the structure during the descent. If accessing the fallen worker's harness is difficult, the rescuer has a couple of options to attach the rescue system. Clipping to the eye of the MGO snap hook works well for a short haul to disconnect the MGO from the anchor and then lower the fallen worker. If using the Absorbica Y tieback lanyard, you can clip to the lanyard's tieback loop to raise the fallen worker and disconnect them from the anchor and lower them. As a final option, the rescue sender rope clamp can be used to connect directly to the rope or webbing lanyard leg. If using the rescue sender, ensure that the connector on the end of the lanyard is not removed in order to prevent the rescue sender from unintentionally coming off the end of the lanyard. Again, once the fallen worker has been disconnected from the anchor and is loaded onto the rescue system, lower them using the I’D EVAC. Now, these were just a few examples of performing a rescue of a fallen worker suspended on a fall arrest lanyard using the JAG Rescue Kit. But for more information and tech tips, please visit Petzl.com.